Welcome to How to Livable. Today, I'm sick, but I'm still going to do this tutorial anyway because it's really cool. And I think perhaps my landlord is working on my heating downstairs, which is causing some serious clanks, so just be aware of that. I want to show you how to make a custom map in Google Maps because it's really pretty cool. Basically, what you do is you go to Google Maps, you need to sign in as yourself, and then you go to My Custom Maps. From there, you want to hit Create, and then you can name your map. Let's call it My Dive Bar Pub Crawl. Save. And then you can start editing it. So anything that I do to this map is going to save it automatically. And let's say I want to add some dive bars to this map because I want a bunch of people to go with me on a dive bar pub crawl. I searched for all these dive bars and they found it in this area, which is great. So that'll give me the details, obviously. So then if I want to save these to my map, let's say I like all of these because they are all kind of in a line. All you gotta do is click on the icon and add it to the map. Boop. And then I have my route, basically. And I can also say, let's say I live in a separate location. Maybe I live... Oh, I just hit this icon, then I gotta click here. What? There we go. Home base. Home base. And then let's say there's another one we're going to end at somewhere else. We're going to end down here in the middle of the river. River end. There we go. Now we have all of our locations, which is great. And basically what I can do is I can draw a line saying, here's where I think we're going to go. We're going to start there. Then we're going to go here. And then we're going to go to these guys. You can go wherever you want here. Do, do, do. And we'll call this our route. And when I'm all done, I can share this with people, which is pretty handy. And you can actually also let them edit it as well. So obviously you can put people's names in here. You can share the link. And when you do that, it's going to ask you if you want to make the map editable from there side as well, which Google actually recommends, because somebody might say, oh, you know what, it's better not to go to this place, or we really have to go to this place, or whatever, and they can add this back on. But that's basically how you do it. This is really handy for stuff like traveling, where you don't know the area very well, and you want to put the locations on in advance, and so it has a lot of applications. The other thing you can do is you can import a CSV, or XLSX file. And these are basically Excel files. If you have a lot of data that you have in an Excel format, you can actually now import those into the map to give you much more advanced functionality and data. And you can add as many of those layers as you want, and you can turn them off and on, which is really handy. So maybe I would have a layer showing the entire topography of this map that I want to also be able to be aware of in case we're stumbling around Chicago. We don't want to trip. We want to know where those high terrain areas are. We've got that. So that's actually something that I'm not very familiar with. I'm sure people watching might be. If you are interested in it, I can probably try and do some more research and do another tutorial. That. At any rate, what I do need you to do, if you enjoyed watching this, please hit subscribe or hit like or leave me a comment. Everyone is appreciated. I'm going to sign off now before my landlord gets too darn loud with his drilling. So I will see you on the next one, or I will see you at another time.